How do you know? Quiz time, answers to how to know when you're being had by a narcissist or other toxic V personality disorder. 1. Pathological lying. How do you know you're with someone who is a pathological liar? People lie, and lie for many reasons, but a pathological liar will lie even when the truth would serve them. For example, when Narc 1 and I were just starting out, we couldn't afford for him to spend $5 a day on lunch, so I made him lunch every day to take to work. He never took it, and continued to spend the money. Finally, one day I asked him how the lunch was that I made for him. He looked me straight in the eye and said it was fine. I opened the fridge, pointed to the bag lunch and said that one. He stared at me blankly then turned around and walked away. Nothing more was said about a lunch. Needless to say, he did this with everything from saying he paid the taxes on a house, we subsequently went into tax sale, to stuffing traffic tickets in the glove box, almost getting his license suspended. So when you catch someone in a lie, listen for more. You might have a pathological liar on your hands. 2. How do you know you've hit a nerve, or bruised an ego? It's in the eyes. I saw this with doctors a lot. If for some reason I was right about a certain condition I had, they would stop for a second, stare blankly, and their eyes would glaze over. Doctors hate to be wrong. 3. How do you know someone is putting on an act? Well, this is a given with a narcissist, but with any other toxic person, I apply the too much rule, and listen for repetition. Over-the-top gestures, and repeating a specific phrase over and over again are definitely giveaways. 4. How do you know they're angry? Let's say this is a person that isn't prone to rages, like the narcissist, and is someone who appears quite cool, most of the time. Answer: passive aggression, where most are their statements are couched as jokes, yet you sense anger just under the surface. They might even throw in little hints as to the reason they're angry, but mostly the humor is forced and peppered with hostile giggles. 5. How do you know someone is envious or jealous? With a narc, this is a big one, because I believe they live their whole life deeply envious of others. So, how can you tell? There is imitation, mirroring, and mimicking. Did you just buy something, then find out the other person bought the same exact thing? Do you notice them copying your mannerisms or even the way you talk? Have you ever heard someone take on a fake accent? Well, if you have, then you've likely been around an extremely toxic person. 6. How do you know someone is screwing you over, specifically a narc? Simple answer, they're being nice. This one became so obvious during my divorce. The narc tried to get me to sign the house over to him. And this was after he complicated the divorce, for attention of course, and told me he was going to have me thrown out of my house. Yep. Then one day, he was so nice to me, he would even go through the trouble of dropping papers off for me to sign. No need to look at them, of course, just trust him and sign. Ha. 7. How do you know you're being gaslit? This is much less obvious, and you'll have to rely on your feelings here. Without doubt, you will feel both confused and anxious. You'll hear yourself say things like, "That doesn't make sense," and "Why are you acting like that?" 8. How do you know your boundaries are being violated, both internal and external? Anger. Anger serves an important emotion here. Even if you can't put your finger on it at the moment, the boundary violation, honor it, and figure out the specifics later. 9. How do you know you're being stonewalled? This is a very subtle abuse tactic, and it basically involves zero cooperation while giving the appearance of cooperating. You will feel frustrated, as your abuser keeps appearing as if to go along with you, but does nothing. Make no mistake, this is intentional, and crazy-making. 10. How do you spot someone with festering, seething rage? Oh, they hide it well. But there are some telltale signs, like road rage, flash anger, and outright raging behavior. The talking through gritted teeth was always a favorite of mine, not. 11. Intentional frustration. This is the quintessential of baby games the narcissist and other toxic bee creatures love to play. Because you mistake these people for actual grown-ups, you will more than likely overlook most of these behaviors, that is, until you blow. Like pinching a little girl on the playground, to tripping your best friend in the hallway, these baby games are meant to piss you off, and satisfy the narc's sadistic idea of fun. Imagine a spoiled rotten four-year-old, getting back at mommy for a time out. Na 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 boo boo is the name of this game. 12. How do you know you're being projected upon? Answer: when the person who's accusing you of something they themselves have done or do. Here, you'll find yourself saying things like, "Hey, I don't do that, that's what you do." Or the crazy making statements of you're having an affair. Chances are real good that the person accusing is actually telling on themselves. 13. How do you know when you've become addicted to the chaos and drama? You feel like shit. For me, I couldn't sleep because of ruminating about what the hell was going on. I was constantly walking on eggshells, I was highly reactive, and was getting sick all the time. I was being worn down, and conditioned to play a part, by reacting to sick psychosis of the narcissist. 14. How can you tell when you're being smeared? For me, this was very subtle, and it was the little school game of I know something you don't know. For example, you know the story of the spouse whose partner is having an affair, and he or she is the last one to know? It's like that. People around you are acting like they know something about you, but aren't saying. That's because they do and they aren't. 15. How do you know you're being sleep deprived other than the obvious? The narc embarks on a noise campaign, and other devious ways of waking you up through the night. In my case, every time I was about to fall asleep, the narc would suddenly have Jimmy legs, or snore really loud. If I tried to sleep in another room, he would rattle the recycling saying he was sorting it, by the way, 3 times a week for a solid 15 minutes. As you all know, it turns out, it never needed to be sorted at all. I've heard other reports of abusers waking their partners up with so-called nightmares, actually punching their significant other in their sleep. Yes, it can get that bad. Just keep in mind here, plausible deniability. The narc, or other toxic B personality disorder, will always say they couldn't help it, and how insensitive you are for complaining about them having a nightmare, or snoring, or recycling at 11 o'clock at night, or whatever. It's always your fault, and they are always the victim of you. And please don't forget it. Really, keep in mind these torturous games, and the reasons for them, and save yourself a lifetime of headache. As for me, I'll be marking the new year with a zero tolerance policy for toxic behavior. Narcs count on you forgetting as they lull you back into a false sense of security, that they either didn't mean it, or that they've somehow changed, and somehow want you to believe you were wrong about them, or were being insensitive, or whatever. The only thing I know for sure is that narcs might change alright, change up their abuse tactics that is. So, be careful out there, and I hope this helped someone today. Love to all, and peace out.